Hey guys, it's Chelsea Messenger from Picks and Parlays. We've got another golf tournament to bet on this weekend. We've got the WGC, FedEx, St. Jude, Invitational at TPC Southwind in Memphis. It's a long name, and it's a loaded field this weekend. This past weekend, the 3M didn't play like a major. We saw a lot of middle-of-the-road names on the leaderboard. I think this weekend, we're going to see a lot of the big boys taking the cake. Here's some of the plays I like this weekend. Justin Thomas is 12-1 to win it all, but I also actually I like him better to finish in the top five at +250. He's obviously one of the favorites for a reason, but I do think he has potential to play even better than he has been because of his short game. It's been lacking by his standards, and traditionally he's been good with the putter. He struggled down the stretch to make some of these putts in the last few tournaments, but he still finished in the top 20 in four of his last five tournaments since the break, along with three top 10s and that second place finish at the Workday. He ranks third on tour on strokes gained approaching the green, which should help with the greens being really small at this course. Justin Thomas is also good against good competition. He's finished 12th or better in six of his last seven WGC events, including last year's tournament here, where he finished tied for 12th. Another bet I really like this weekend is Daniel Berger at even money to finish in the top 20. Daniel Berger has won this tournament twice. He's finished first twice. I repeat that. So the fact that you get him at even money to finish in the top 20 is a bet that I really like. Daniel Berger has also played pretty good golf since the restart. He did miss the cut at the Memorial, but won the Charles Schwab Challenge and finished third at RBC Heritage, which is another course where putting is key. And finally, I like Tommy Fleetwood to finish in the top 20 at +125. I think you get a little bit more value here on a really good golfer to finish in the top 20 just because he did miss the cut at the 3M Open. However, it was his first tournament back since the restart. I think he was shaking off some rust, and he's one of those guys that play really well against tough competition. He's finished top 20 at four of his last six WGC events, including a fourth place finish at this event last year. Those are my plays. Good luck.